Hello everybody and welcome back to Koswas Gaming. Today we are going to play the Crown Championship Final Challenge. As you can see, I haven't entered the challenge yet and let's see how we're going to do. But let's first open this super magical chest and see if we're going to get anything good. Some knights, some mortars, 8 executioners. These are good to give to my other clanmates. It is 500 gold each. Some battle rams, 16 wits. Again, these are okay to give to the other people. I don't use wits. And it seems that we have a legendary. Let's see what it is. Hopefully one that I don't already have. And it is a Sparky. I do have Sparkies. One more and I can make it level 3. Okay, so it wasn't very good, other than some gold. So let's try the Crown Championship Final Challenge. Here it goes up to 20 wins. In order to win 250,000 gold, that is a lot. Hopefully we are going to go to around this area. I will be very happy if we get 10 wins. Usually these challenges are not very easy, so I will be happy with any reward we get. So let's see how we're going to do. So the deck that we're going to be using is the normal Baby Dragon Balloon deck that I have shown you on my previous videos. And let's start. Okay, so should we play aggressive or not? That is the question. I can place the giant skeleton and the minions. I will place the giant skeleton and the minions. Maybe the minions. Okay, the minions will do some work there because the tornado. Also, I don't think he needed to use the tornado, so I think overall it was okay. I'm going to use the bomb tower in defensive position. And now I have shuffled my cards enough and I can use the baby dragon and the balloon. So I place the baby dragon on the bottom right corner. I will place the balloon in front of it. The baby dragon is going to push the balloon. I'm going to freeze everybody here, which it is going to work perfectly, especially this infernal dragon, because it can destroy my balloon very fast. Overall, we did a very nice damage, and actually I'm going to shoot the arrows, so I damage the dragon and the tower. Now I have to do something with these goblins on the left side. And I'm going to place the musketeer. I think it was a good place because we can counter also the graveyard. He has also the poison, but overall we are doing fine. Let's see what the baby dragon is going to do. Finds another baby dragon. Now I'm going to place the giant skeleton here, so that is going to aggro everybody. I'm going to place the balloon and let's see if it is going to make it. For just some pixels, didn't make it there. I'm going to place the musketeer here and the minions on the other side, and I have to place the baby dragon here because these are many skeletons. Let's see, one hit. Okay, he did make one hit. Hopefully he doesn't have any rocket, which he might have. I'm going to put the arrows so I can put everything to be, so the baby dragon might do some damage there. I'm going to place, and let's see if we're going to make it. 416 damage. I'm very used to the the arrows that make 130 damage, and I thought that we're going to make that one, but apparently the challenge level arrows don't make a lot of damage, so that was an important point there. So let's see. Game number two, Africano Plays from Claflas BSD. I'm going to place the giant skeleton on the back. He places his giant on the back. Let's see how that is going to play out. I'm going to play the bomb tower in order to counter his giant. Ooh, a little bit to the back than I wanted it, but it is going to do the job. I'm going to place a little bit to the front, and I have to arrow those because they do a lot of damage. There, it wasn't a very good play because the baby dragon was getting hit by the executioner and I couldn't do something about that. I'm going to place the musketeer on the back, and maybe I will place the giant skeleton in front of it. Yes. And let's see how he's going to counter that. He's going to use the skeleton horde, but he didn't wait for the skeletons to go to, for my musketeer to pass the bridge, so he kind of didn't do this very, very correctly. I'm going to place actually the bomb tower because this executioner scares me a lot. And you know, the bomb of my giant skeleton also destroyed the goblin gang, and now it is time for my baby dragon balloon trick. He's going to place the archers, and I'm going to freeze everything. He has also 'Electro Wizard', and he has a lot of stuff coming. I think we lost this game as well. It seems that he has it under control, and he has a simple deck. I should have been able to do that. Everything was at the play in the beginning where his executioner did a lot of damage to my tower. I couldn't go back out from it. And second straight lose on this challenge. As I told you, this challenge is it was expected to be tough because it gives nice rewards, especially if you do 20 wins, it's 250,000. That is insane. Well, hopefully we're going to get just the first reward. Okay, he plays the knight on my left side. I play the musketeer on the back. He's going to use the rocket. I'm going to place a giant skeleton in front of my tower. And I don't know why he used this ice spirit, probably in order to reshuffle his his cards. I am going to put all of my epic cards now. He has an executioner. I'm going to freeze everything. And hopefully we're going to do some damage to the tower. And we got the tower. So now the question is if we should go all defense or we should try to get the tower on the right. He has a hog rider, which we counter easily. I think he's going to continue coming to my left side, so I will be placing all my defensive troops to my left. and hopefully that is going to be enough. He's going to rock it again, let's see. And he didn't make the tower, I think. So that was very weird play. And I will place my baby dragon and balloon. I'm going to place the minions after the ice spirit because the ice spirit can damage them and kill them. Especially if he has a zap. And I think we made also the second tower. No, I think this was... Oh my god, again. Now he missed the... He missed the actual musketeer. So... He goes for the win. And... I think if when I have two losses, especially one next to each other, I think the game kind of gives you a break and puts you with opponents that also have many losses. So that's why I think we won this so easily. And we may win a couple of more, hopefully, like that, because I have two losses. So I play with all of the people that already have two losses too, and let's see how it is going to work out. So first win in this crown championship finals challenge. Now I have a very nice opening deck. I have the baby dragon and the balloon coming up, so I will use them. And I already gained a couple of elixirs versus my opponent. I am going to place it and I'm going to be ready for the freeze, which gets everybody. Unfortunately, my baby dragon doesn't hit the tower as well. That's a little bit far away, but it is going to do the trick. And I will place the minions near the wizard because it does a lot of damage. Unfortunately, he did a nice damage to my tower. I was able to do a lot of damage to his tower as well. Okay, so he has a Sparky, so that is getting countered by my giant skeleton. Actually, my giant skeleton seems to be, it might counter everything if we get the... Yeah, so my giant skeleton in theory is going to counter everybody there because it is going to destroy this. We need to counter for just a little bit. I didn't have enough elixir to place my balloon in front of my baby dragon, but it seems the baby dragon, it did the trick. So now I have to defend my right side tower because he needs to get this tower. So he's going to do his best in order to get this tower. I don't understand why. Well, he's probably going for the win, basically to get both of my towers at the same time. That's why he goes to for my left side. And that was a bit weird because I thought that is not going to be... Oh, this needs to be frozen and arrows. That was a little bit dangerous there because the bomb from my giant skeleton didn't actually catch the Sparky. Now he doesn't have a lot of time. He needs to do something, or probably he cannot do something. So hopefully we're going to win it. Hopefully it doesn't have any rocket or mirror rocket or something. So we managed to do the second one. As I told you, now we are playing with people that probably have two losses already. That means they don't play very nicely, like me. And we got our first 2,000. So that is That is exciting. That is something. Let's continue and see how far we can go. Okay, so my starting hand is not very good. I will have to play defensively. I will place just the bomb tower in defensive position here. So he has the tombstone. That means he may have legendary flying. No, he has. Ooh, he has the bow. Okay, so my giant skeleton is going to do a very good job there now. Hopefully, yes, he did. And I will place the musketeer. And now I have my baby dragon balloon cards here. So he's going to destroy my musketeer with the rocket. But that helps us because the rocket actually counters my baby dragon and balloon, because it is a very nice hit there. Now my baby dragon actually pushed the balloon very far away, and we are going to do some very nice damage, and we are going to place the bomb tower in defensive position. So I do that because his bow is going to be in a nice range with my tower, and this bomb tower, it kind of messes up with his strategy. As you can see, he's going to place it in order to destroy my bomb tower first. I'm going to defend using my giant skeleton, and actually I'm going to place my musketeer so I can take away the archer. We made another win, so three wins in a row, while we got two losses in a row in the beginning. This game we play with Alve from BD class. We don't have anything in order to counter this, so I'm going to place the minions and the musketeer. Let's see what he has for that. The minions. Okay, so he placed the electro wizard. That was okay. So now we are going to place the baby dragon. And then I'm going to place the balloon in front of it, and I will have ready the freeze. It is good that he placed electro wizard to counter my musketeer, because the counters my combo here, because as you can see, it is two cards and they will be damaged at the same time and they will get disrupted. I place my bomb tower in defensive position. That actually helps in order to counter anything coming in our way. So he placed the minion horde. I can counter with the arrows. that is going to be a 3 crown win. And we get the 30 cards. I'm hoping for musketeers or bomb towers. Let's see what we are going to get. And it is 30 musketeers, so that it was perfect. So let's see if we're going to go and get these 5 epic cards here. So we need 2 more wins in order to do that. And let's see what we're going to get from this box. It has 12 cards, 10 skeletons and 1 golem, so nothing that we use. And that was it. So in this we did 4 wins in a row. We managed to get the 30 musketeers, and we also managed to get the first gold rewards that they had. Tomorrow is going to be the last day of the current season, so I will try to push the trophies. Hopefully we can reach at the challenger number 3. So thank you for watching and stay tuned for my next video.